Hey guys, welcome to the next part in the All Regen Liverpool series, and this game is against Norwich. Former Liverpool player Tony Crichton here, many, many moons ago, hasn't when he was only a youngster. We're talking like, here 2000 and, well, 2016. It's quite far into the game, but, on the face of it here, I mean, he's played for Everton. A lot of my former players have joined Everton. It's not good, is it? Anyway, we've got a young, fairly young defence, I suppose. Dan Liddle, Goller and Shugol playing. Wheel obviously adding a bit of age to that that defence. We've also got Maloney in midfield with Joe Jackson up front and Fredinho. Yeah, let's get into it. It is the final game of 2030, so we're halfway through the season, I think. Yeah, that's halfway through the season. Let's give the fans something to cheer. Do that for once. It doesn't actually stir that much up unless, like, you've got a team of local lads on. Really recommend using that one too often, like I've just done there. I've used that like once or twice this season. So yeah, Ryan Bergen getting a chance instead of what's he called, Forbes. Once still can't fucking help Fredinho, he cannot score. Dan Liddle playing at left back and trying to rotate the squad a little bit. He is capable. He's not the most capable. He was light green, I think his colour was for it, so that means he is capable. Not the best recommended, I suppose, if you need to, which I guess I needed to, because I also got the big game against Chelsea coming up in a few days' time. Why on earth we're playing Chelsea so quickly, I have no idea, and Fredinho is offside there. It's annoying, actually, because he hasn't scored that many goals, Fredinho, this season. I don't know if his age is catching up to him or what, but he can't seem to find the net, which is rare, because he's been our top goal scorer for like the last 10 or 15 years. 15, about there. Yeah, he's been our top goal scorer for like 10 years. Nearly, alongside Goetz. Who, of course, now is retired, I think. I think he had a short spell at being a as an assistant manager, Noah Goetz, but our great number 9, of course. But he is now retired anyway. Here's Fredinho on this free kick. Sadler would usually be on these, but he has dropped. Well, he's not dropped, actually. He's rested for the Chelsea game. I think is he on the bench? Yeah, he's on the bench. You can see him there, number 8. Silvani, also on the bench, who made a decent impression last time. Bergen. Oh, Ryan Bergen, he's old Bergen, because him and Forbes are very, very similar players. But, and Brown hits the bar. Yeah, they're very similar players, but I don't know, Bergen just seems to do just a little bit more. I don't know what it is. He just adds that extra something else. I can't quite put my finger on. Yeah. I don't know why I can explain it, but yeah, it's he's gone with them. I'm gonna call it mojo, shall we say? I don't know. Maybe that's an overused word. I don't know. Anyway, say it's a younger defence here, so when these centre forwards get forward, makes sense. When the strikers get forward, then hopefully they won't back off too much. Got Lee Barton also, for those who didn't notice, Lee Barton, the young goalkeeper in goal. Just, again, to aid his development. Speaking of a youngster, here's Jackson. Really doing particularly well at the moment. Young ones are actually doing really well. It's the oldies that are letting me down. Fredinho, Wheeler, were starters there. And Jackson's done very well to win a goal, to win a corner there. I don't know how he's done that. Wheeler, very slow to move there. Reaction time going a bit. So again, I think it's this control. I keep forgetting to change from control. It's done us fine for like the last 10 years. I don't know why I've had to change it. New breed of players, I suppose. Oh, Fredinho. It's not going to go in for him. Oh my god. It is just not going to go in for him at the moment. Oh dear. Oh, off the line by Taylor. God. That one wasn't Fredinho though, so it's not too bad. Yeah, it's quite hard to break Norwich down at the moment. Come on. I realise this is a young team, but, it's not that bad. I don't think that's Robert. It might actually. Is that Robert Green? No, Alan Green. He's, of course, a regen. He's from New Zealand. Seen too many of them. Oop. About to dish out a few contracts there as well. I always leave, I think stupidly actually, leave it until the 6 month, sorry, until it comes up and saying there is 6 months left before his contract runs out. Probably shouldn't do that, but yeah, that's how I work it, just so it's easier. It just reminds me, push it to the edge. Don't know what for, but yeah. Chance for Fredinho, finally. Oh, it's another former player on goal. It's not on a Fredinho goal, unfortunately, but nevertheless, it's a goal for us. It's another former goal. I've had so many now. I've had Jack Robinson in the past. I don't know what on earth he tried to do there. Hook it away, maybe, and it went wrong for him. I don't know. I think we've had a few others score on goals for us, former players of mine. Ooh, chance for, ooh, nearly a chance for Jackson. Let's get on the end of that. Here he is now, though. Blocked. Yeah, Norwich quite, well, apart from that moment of stupidity from Crichton there, see why I didn't keep hold of him. yeah, apart from that, they've looked quite solid, to be fair. Chance, though, from this. See? Solid. Try and jinx him inappropriately. Little's actually looked okay again, and far from the game, of course, his debut where he scored an own goal, but then rectified it straight away. Fredinho still cannot score. This is ridiculous. Won't run for us, will it? These chances. To be fair, we did have a huge slice of luck, though. To be fair, that Crichton own goal. Very big slice. Waiting for half time now, should be coming in a moment. Oh, they've had a penalty. Oh, nearly a penalty. Fredinho will take, he's gonna have a shot, surely. I think he did as well. I think that was a shot. What a stupid decision. Oh, excuse me. Looks stressed. God, it's like no pressure, I suppose. Well, that didn't do anything. Might just. I have to say that because they're just not. Well, Jackson has been okay, but Fredinho needs to get his arse in gear. Might have to have a personal chat with him as well. Because Jackson. Oh, and that's a good save. Brown, he's on target with his shots lately. Well, nearly. Hit the bar a few times. Don't know if that counts as on target or not. And ah, there we go. Second goal. And it's Goller, the 19-year-old centre back. He has. Great potential, as we all saw a few seasons ago, and he's put it to good use. The moment he's bring him in the team, gets in front of his man, and that's a good header. So 2-0 now, hopefully, as long as we keep the concentration as I told them to, so they should, this game looks as good as done. But don't count it out yet. Don't skip forward. Oh, Brown again. Shooting is just it's very hit and miss. Brown, he can hit, well, as we saw, you know, in previous games, you know, he can half hit a ball, then the other times he'll just I don't know, flap at it, I suppose is the term, where he'll not flap at it, sort of just fluff his lines, I suppose is the term, and he just looks awful. But in this one he's done well. Oh my god, it's still not going for him. Fredinho, I don't know how long it's been since he scored, but yeah, he's having a horrible time out there at the moment. But the youngsters again doing very, very well. I mean, Brown, see what I mean about shooting? Not the best shot in the world, but there you go. Maloney, as I say, really has stepped up. I mean, he hasn't been featured in the last few games, just I don't know why, but yeah, I don't know. I'm just not sad enough to feature him, I suppose. You know, big games, Everton, United, and so on. Yeah, I'm going to take Fredinho off. I know he's the captain and so on, but I'm going to bring on. Oh, I don't have Aiden Taylor. That's a shame. I'm bringing Silvani on. Scored in the last. Was it the last game? Last few games, I think. I can't remember. Anyway, yeah. Anytime he's actually come on, he's looked good, Silvani. So I can't knock him. Speaking of which, I still need to put the players on attacking set pieces. Thing, because you know that training individual thing, whatever it is. Sorry, it's a special training focus, that's the one. Tom Wheeler will probably be leaving at the end of the season. He's getting old, getting on a bit now. He's 35. Oh, and Silvani should scored. Not making a good case why I should start you. Silvani, you're terrible. Anyway, keep going here with... Oh, chance for Novello. And Jackson knocks it in. And I don't know how many goals he's scored now. Jackson, 17. I think he's still, bear in mind, 17, 18 years old. And he's getting a fair few goals. And I'll actually have a look at his stats at the end if I remember. Oh, excuse me. Come out to him. Right place, right time. But unlucky for the goalkeeper. Never mind. Never mind, Green. So that's 3-0. This game is set and match. And all that way with phrases. we will take off then. Who shall we take off? I don't think I need to take anyone else off, really. I think I need to bring anyone else on. Give May a 10 minutes, I suppose. 15 minutes, I suppose. Maloney's done exceptionally well in this AP role. The attacking, the advanced playmaker role. Can't knock him. Had a good game again. Not sure if he's ready for the step up against Chelsea, but... you never know, in the future, possibly. Oh, and slop, well, I was going to say sloppy, stupid play, but equally as bad shooting there from the player, Norwich player, whoever that was. Exceptionally young defence, I say, if you include the goalkeeper, Liddle, I think, is like 18 or 19. Goller is like 19. Shug's only like 25 himself. Wheeler's 35, with the exception of him. And you have the goalkeeper who's 17 or 16 or 17. The average age, what's that average age be? 19, 20? You know, that's a long, especially defenders as well. You know, how long they can go for, as per scene, Wheeler. He's 35. Cartazzola, don't forget as well, he's like 33. So, you know, I've got that sort of mix of experienced defenders as well as very young defenders. Admittedly, when they're young, they're very young. When they're old, they're very old. The only real player who's down the middle... I suppose it's Shu, who's like 25. I suppose James as well, who is like 22, who will be going to the African Cup of Nations, should point out. Paul James, the commanding Nigerian centre-back, he will be pissing off to the African Cup of Nations, which is a pain in the arse. But what can you do? That's what every manager has to deal with, I suppose. Hopefully Nigeria will have a good tournament. Everyone always hopes that they do poorly. You're like, the guy's team does poorly. I hope he has a good tournament, but I hope the team do poorly. Yeah, let's be honest, we all do. You know, when Drogba and Touré and who else, Kalou and likes all piss off, I'm sure, you know, you wish them well, but at the same time, you don't, to be honest. Anyway, I think I was going to say one last final attack, but Wheeler puts it out. So that's another good victory for us. We are slowly gaining momentum. And it was Renato Novello who, no, it wasn't, it was Goller who's man of the match. Novello also had a good game. He deserved a goal, a good win. And on to the new year. So we will play Chelsea on the 1st of January 2031. Let's have a look at that table then. We'll also have a look at Jackson's stats so far. It's so generic. Club rumour is still linking with a player transfer. No, it's not. No, he's not. Fuck off. Look at the league table then. This is how it stands. 20 games going into the new year. City light top. 6 points clear of us in Tottenham. We are ahead of Tottenham on goal difference. 5 more goals. We scored 3 and conceded 2 less. Looking at the stats real quick. Assists. So as you can see, Sadler has 11. Forbes also up there with 7 and goals. Castillo and Suarez both have 7. Wiltshire has 6. Big gap then to Trevor Sadler with 4. Jackson and Silvani. Jackson has 3. Don't forget that exclude. This is only the league, excluding Europe. Bergen and Forbes with 2. And yeah, so... yeah, you see what I mean there. Let's have a look at... Where is Jackson's stats? Let's say the lad's 17. Worth 4.2 million. Dubbed the new Kevin Davis. I think he's going to be a bit better than that. He's from Salford, typically. let's see, I mean... 6 goals... In, what, 10 appearances? And 2 assists? I mean, you can't fault that. So let's go to his attributes. I mean, obviously, I'm not the best, I will admit. I am not the best at reading stats. I do often. I mean, obviously, I realise I probably should play him as a target man, and obviously, I don't change it when he comes off the bench. But he's a big lad, as you can see. You know, I'm not the best at reading stats. If you like that whole thing, then here's your chance. But you know, 6 goals, as I say, with the 3 in the league and the 3 in Europe, in 10 appearances, 6 in the league and 3. Is it 6? 3. Oh yeah, and 1 in the cup. So you know, that's excellent, I suppose. And if it's just 8 starts as well, so you cannot knock that. That is very good. Here's his report, as I say, 3.5 stars. Leading Premier Division striker. You know, we're talking up there with Fredinho, Suarez. Fredinho's rating has finally drifted to 3.5, which is a shame. There you go. So next up, Stamford Bridge, as we take on Chelsea, the European champions. Now, technically, on this game, Bayern Munich are, but it is a totally different team, I should point out. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, lads. Give the video a like if you want, and thank you for watching. Bye bye.